There must always be a Stark in Winterfell. We hear this line numerous times throughout the course of the A Song of Ice and Fire novels and Game of Thrones the TV show. At first it seemed an innocuous thing, some egotistical rhetoric a great lord might conjure to reaffirm the legitimacy of his claim to rule. But what if there's more to it than that? What if the saying is a literal omen, a warning, a condition that needs to be met lest something great and terrible should occur as consequence? Winterfell is an interesting place. It's a huge, sprawling castle spanning several acres and made up of a number of buildings all fortified behind two massive walls. But as large as Winterfell is on the surface, what lies beneath it is more massive still. A subterranean labyrinth of narrow passages and cavernous depths known as the Crypt of Winterfell, where dead Starks are interred and past kings made effigy. Mention of the crypts and its implication is a recurring theme throughout the fiction. Jon Snow is haunted by strange dreams tied to the place, nightmarish visions that seem almost beckoning. Bran Stark maintains a sense of connection through the crypts, understanding that they are a part of who he is and that ultimately, therein lies his fate. Through careful narrative weaving and thematic sleight of hand, George R.R. Martin intentionally guides our mind's eye towards these crypts, suggesting that their significance is greater than we could have at first imagined, and that somewhere beneath the Stark ancestral home may lie something dark and terrible, and that maybe the only thing keeping this entity at bay was a Stark in Winterfell. Winterfell was supposedly raised over 8,000 years ago by the legendary folk hero Bran the Builder. It's said that it was built with the help of giants and that it was done so after the Long Night, a period in which the known world was plunged into a winter that lasted an age, and the others emerged from the far north bringing with them terror and death. It was only after their defeat in the Battle for the Dawn that the Wall and Winterfell were raised. Now we know why the wall was raised, to keep the others from ever returning, but what about Winterfell? Was it simply built as a place for Bran the Builder to found his house? Or like the wall, is there more to it than that? The name alone, Winterfell, has connotations that can't be mere chance. There is a theory that the crypts beneath Winterfell serve as more than just a cavern for the entombed, that they are a prison made by Bran the Builder to contain the Great Other, the god of darkness, cold, and death, enemy of the Lord of Light, and that its imprisonment is predicated on an enchantment that states, "There must always be a Stark in Winterfell." The Starks are gone from Winterfell, and even if Jon should reclaim the castle, if the theory behind his true parentage is to be believed, he is no Stark. Melisandre, envoy of R'hllor, Lord of Light, senses that the Great Other grows stronger and perhaps he has new champions. The sepulchres of the Kings of Winter who dwell within the crypt sit with stone direwolves curled at their feet and iron longswords laid across their laps to keep the vengeful spirits in their crypts. Upon escaping Winterfell, Bran, along with Mira and Jojen Reed and Hodor, removed some of these swords so that they might defend themselves out in the wild. A convenient plot device or something more meaningful? There are many theories surrounding the crypts beneath Winterfell. Some state that a dragon dwells deep within the recesses of the earth, and others that therein lies a god. What do you think? Are these just the whispers of the small folk? Or is there something more sinister lying in wait? Thanks a lot for watching, guys. As you know, theories surrounding A Song of Ice and Fire are always, in a sense, we the fans grasping at straws, but it's an essential part of what makes reading and rereading these novels so much fun, and what makes the A Song of Ice and Fire community so rewarding to be a part of. I'm unsure who the originator of this particular theory was, so forgive my ignorance in that regard, but be sure to check out the A Song of Ice and Fire wiki and subreddit for more insightful and fun theories surrounding the fiction. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you again soon.